All right, folks, welcome back here to another episode of The Corner. Today it will mainly just be me and myself here today, as my partner Troy was not able to come to the phone right now. So I wanted to discuss this a little bit with you, that we might not see Better Call Saul season 6 before 2022, but potentially what they're going to do is that they will split the season in half, like they did with Breaking Bad, which aired then into different stages. And I think that's likely that we're going to see happen due to this COVID-19 pandemic and all the crap that follows of that. But it will still be like really interesting to see what they will do. Because like the showrunners have said that they might need more time to complete the story. And as we have just learned, is that they are now writing episode 8 in season 6. And it's not going to be just 10 episodes like the previous ones. It's going to be 13 episodes for season 6. So that's going to be, again, interesting to see what they are going to do. I can read a little bit here from you from cheatsheet.com/entertainment. With or without production shutdowns, the writers will benefit from having more time to tell the story, and as a bonus for fans, splitting the final season 6 into 2 parts would mean getting to see the initial efforts sooner. Hypothetically, the first half could be released as early as 2021. And the second in 2022. Otherwise, it's more realistic to see the entire 6th season in 2022. Again, just the same as I just said with the coronavirus pandemic causing delays. But on the plus side, this would give the writers plenty of time to answer questions like what happened to Kim Wexler and when precisely Jimmy McGill turns in and becomes 100% Saul Goodman. It will also finish up the flash forward scenes with Gene Takovich and show exactly what becomes of Jimmy. I kind of like Bob Odenkirk's take on it, that he'd like to see Gene come out of hiding. That's going to be like a really interesting to see what happens to him. Like, How I'm seeing it is that either he goes back out of hiding, he ends up in prison, or he offs himself. But I don't really see that happening, that he offs himself. It was just like as a thought regarding that Chuck killed himself, right? Furthermore, whether the premiere happens in 2021 or later, we are still waiting, you know, like a final answer from AMC. So it would be like really nice to see them actually coming up with it. I did like learn something interesting though. And that is that in Breaking Bad, Jimmy or Saul showed 2 times sides of his humanity, which was like kind of weird because it was out of character for him in Breaking Bad to do so. One was when he tells Walter at some point that he should quit and get out of the game, and the second was when he actually goes to visit that Hispanic lady that Jesse was dating, the one that had a kid. And yeah, it was interesting that it's like those 2 moments where he actually showed some humanity regarding himself, and not just the Saul Goodman side without any morals. I don't know. What else is there to say about what we could wait for in season 6? A short intermission here before we continue to record. Intermission there. So where was I going? Yeah, that the next season is going to be 13 episodes, which means that the entire show of Better Call Saul is going to land on a total of 63 episodes. That's one more than Breaking Bad. I don't know why I'm laughing. I'm just like in a happy mood today, I guess, even though I'm a little sick. Still, I can't wait until we see the next season of Better Call Saul, just like you guys. And it will be interesting to see if we will see any more Breaking Bad cameos, such as we did with Dean Norris reprising his role as Hank Schrader, and the reprising role of Steven Gomez. So yeah, that will be like fun. Maybe we'll see like Walter or Jesse reprising in the next season. However, the more interesting parts will be what happens to Lalo and what happens to Nacho, and if we will see that Ed gets introduced, like I've talked about before, if Ed gets introduced via Mike to disappear Nacho, since he wants out of the game. But Gustavo does not want to let him get out of the game. Now, I think that's it. And except for that, there's also what happens to Kim, because like Bob Odenkirk himself said, I'm sorry, I'm gonna cough here a little bit. Yeah, like Bob Odenkirk himself said that he don't think that Kim is a character that can stay when he goes full Saul Goodman. So then she needs to leave, but not necessarily going to get killed off. So I'm like thinking that either she's just going to go on with her life, or she's going to become institutionalized. I'm sorry, I'm gonna cough again. God damn. Yeah, that's what I think. And I will continue to make more of these videos. And I hope that you will watch, listen, and subscribe. And yeah, leave a comment about like what you think. I think that, you know, this is going to be the shortest ever episode of The Corner, since I end this for the first time ever. Don't have somebody to, you know, like ballpark thoughts and shit about what's going to happen in Better Call Saul. And it's kind of like weird, you know, like just talking to myself here in front of a camera about what I think is going to happen. Share, comment, and subscribe, guys. Peace out. I can play like one more song for you before we end it. Thank you. All right, guys. Well, that was just like a short intermission there from Willie Birkin, Kein Problem from 1943. Like, I'm sorry, like, I gotta use like these songs that's public domain, or else the video's going to be copyright infringed or some shit like that. And I am trying to even how unlikely it seems now, I am trying to get on the road to 1,000 subscribers. And even though I have only 28 of you, I am grateful for every one and each of you. And I hope that you will continue to sharing the word of these recordings and get the word out there and get more subscribers. Thanks, folks. And have a nice Sunday.